हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सोनू यादव। टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज हिमेटोपोइसिस। हिमेटोपोइसिस इट इज़ डिफाइंड एज द फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ब्लड सेल्स। इट इज़ नोन एज हिमेटोपोइसिस, दैट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑल ब्लड सेल्स। So, coming on to blood, what is blood? Blood is a component which provide mechanism for rapid transport of nutrients, waste products, respiratory gases and various cells. So, when a blood subjected to centrifugation, it separates in three layers. That is the upper layer, the clear layer is plasma. It constitute approximately 55%. And the middle layer is buffy coat. It constitute approximately 1% of all. Now the lowermost layer, it constitute 45%. That is red blood cells. Now coming on to plasma. It consists of water, approximately 90%, and other things are clotting factors, nutrients, waste material, and blood gases. Now, buffy coat, it comprises of platelets and white blood cells, that is WBC. White blood cells, they are of two types based on the presence of cytoplasmic granules in their cytoplasmic granules. They are divided into agranulocytes and granulocytes. Agranulocytes, when there is absence of any granules in the cytoplasm, they are known as agranulocyte. The examples are lymphocyte and monocyte. Granulocyte, the cell containing granules in their cytoplasm, is known as granulocytes, and the examples are neutrophil, basophil and eosinophil. These all are the mature white blood cells, and this is the composition of blood. That is, it constitute 55% plasma, 45% RBC and 1% buffy coat, which is comprises of platelets and white blood cells. Then further, white blood cells are divided into agranulocytes and granulocytes. Now the formed elements of blood or various blood cells are red cells, or also known as erythrocyte, granulocytes, that is neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. Then lymphocytes and monocytes, these are the example of agranulocytes. Platelet. All these formed elements of blood, they have a common origin, that is from hematopoietic stem cells in the bone marrow. So all the formed elements of blood or various types of mature blood cells, they have a common origin, that is in the bone marrow, and they develop from hematopoietic stem cell. Hematopoietic stem cells, they are characterized by self-renewal, differentiation, proliferative capacity. So formation of red blood cell is known as erythropoiesis, because red blood cells are also known as erythrocyte. So it is known as erythropoiesis. Formation of white blood cell known as myelopoiesis, because they are also known as myeloid series. Formation of platelet megakaryocyte is known as megakaryopoiesis, as the platelets are also known as megakaryocyte. So formation of red blood cell is known as erythropoiesis. Formation of white blood cell is known as myelopoiesis. Formation of platelet or megakaryocyte is known as megakaryopoiesis. Now, myelopoiesis. It consists of three series of cells, that is granulocyte series, monocyte macrophage series, and lymphoid series. All these arises from common myeloid progenitor. Now, this is overview of how these mature cells develop. So they are originating from hematopoietic stem cell in the bone marrow, and hematopoietic stem cell, it is characterized by high proliferative potential, self renewal and differentiation. So hematopoietic stem cell, it will give rise to two progenitor, that is common myeloid progenitor and common lymphoid progenitor. Common myeloid progenitor or colony forming unit, granulocyte, erythroid, monocyte, macrophage. This will give rise to colony forming unit, megakaryocyte, erythroid. Now, colony forming unit megakaryocyte erythroid will give rise to colony forming unit megakaryocyte and colony forming unit erythroid. Erythroid will give rise to erythrocyte, and megakaryocyte will give rise to megakaryocyte will further give rise to platelets. Now, colony forming unit granulocyte macrophage will give rise to colony forming unit granulocyte, colony forming unit macrophage, colony forming unit eosinophil, colony forming unit basophil. Now this will mature into basophil, this will mature into eosinophil, this will give rise to monocyte, and in the tissues it become macrophage, and this will give rise to neutrophil. And now coming on to the common lymphoid progenitor, it give B cell, T cell, natural killer cell. B cell, they give rise to plasma cell. So this is an overview of how these mature blood cells are arising from the bone marrow. They are originating from a common hematopoietic stem cell, which will give rise to common myeloid progenitor and common lymphoid progenitor. Common lymphoid progenitor will give rise to B cell, T cell, natural killer cell. And the common myeloid progenitor will give rise to platelet, erythrocyte, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, monocyte. That will go into tissue and mature into macrophage. So these are the formed elements in blood. Now this coming on to the site. Site for blood formation varies with age. At third week of embryonic life, the hematopoiesis start. It starts in York sac in the form of blood islands. Then around third month of fetal life, mainly liver is involved in hematopoiesis. Other organs involved are lymph nodes, spleen and thymus, but liver is the main. Then around 4 months of fetal life and after birth, bone marrow is the main site of hematopoiesis. That is formation of all blood cells. The active sites of hematopoiesis is pelvis, vertebra, skull, ribs, sternum, proximal end of long bones. These are the sites of bone marrow. Because around 4 months of fetal life and after birth, hematopoiesis take place in bone marrow. So these are the active site of hematopoiesis. Now, regulation of hemopoiesis. Hemopoiesis is regulated by three main factors, that is local environment, hemopoietic growth factors and apoptosis. It is regulated when these all three have a balance between them. So what are local environment, local factors? The local environment means bone marrow microenvironment. It is maintained by stromal cells. Various stromal cells are mesenchymal cells, stem cells, fat cells, fibroblast, osteoblast, endothelial cell. These all are example of stromal cells. These stromal cells, they secrete hematopoietic growth factors and they help in interaction between these hematopoietic factors and hematopoietic stem cells with each other. And what are the examples of hematopoietic growth factors? Early acting growth factors and late acting. Early acting are stem cell factor, interleukin 3, interleukin 6, and late acting are granulocyte colony stimulating factor, macrophage colony stimulating factor, erythropoietin, thrombopoietin, and various interleukins. These are the growth factors which help in hematopoiesis, regulation of blood cell formation. And these growth factors, they are secreted by bone marrow microenvironment cells, that is stromal cells, which are comprising of osteoblast, fibroblast, fat cell, stem cell. Both cells and signals contribute to hematopoietic stem cell maintenance, mobilization, homing, and differentiation. They will regulate and maintain the stem cells. So, if there is a balance between microenvironment growth factors, hematopoietic growth factors and apoptosis, all the unwanted cells are removed by a process known as programmed cell death, that is apoptosis. If these three factors have a balance between them, then hematopoiesis is regulated. So this is all about today's lecture.